Applaud, Jack and Alessandro.
Thank you, Sam. Well, good morning, everyone. Thanks for choosing our session over the other sessions. My name's Jack from Lee Consulting. We're an independent MarTech measurement and data consultancy, and I'm delighted that Alessandro has agreed to talk to us today about how HSBC are overcoming some of their marketing measurement challenges. So, Alessandro, welcome. We've only got 14 and a half minutes, which is staring at me, so let's get straight into it. HSBC, obviously, it's a big brand, complex organisation, lots of marketing across lots of different channels. What are the core challenges that you're trying to solve in measurement right now at HSBC?
Yeah, thank you for the question. It's a good question. I think that the big challenge itself, it is measurement, like, and bringing together different things. Like, I think, like, I was here listening to the other presentations before, very interesting. And I think I'm not saying anything new, saying that, like, it's a complex world. It's a complex issue to tackle. And it's becoming more complex and more difficult to tackle because, as we know, like, there are changes happening, like, at different levels, platform levels, ITP, probably before ITP it was Firefox, I guess, then Apple with ITP, more recently ATT, all these three-letter acronyms that are coming at us marketers and kind of making our lives a bit more complicated. So those changes are happening. There are changes happening on the policy level. So regulators are becoming more stringent. There is more attention to data privacy overall. And I think, like, GDPR has been there for a while. It is, I think, in spirit, a great thing. There are still so many gray areas to cover and to let's say try to clarify. That doesn't necessarily make our life easier. Although I recognize it is an important part, and that's the direction of travel anyway. So platforms, media platforms and policies, like, are two key components. And I think the third one is probably people. Yeah, so the society overall, like, people are more interested in or interested in their data, understanding their data and how their data are used. And I think there is a challenge into the challenge here, because, like, every time I look, like, at any survey, I can see two kinds of surveys. One survey tells me people want personalized experiences. That's what they want on top of everything else. And they want to feel like they're actually, you know, that the, what they go through, like, is bespoke, it's that they're made for them. But at the same time, they don't want to share their data. There is, like, this fear of sharing data, which is, again, a challenge into a challenge, because how you reconcile this. The way you do it, probably, I mean, the long-term solution is education for sure. Although education is not something we can tackle as HSBC or even, like, as an industry, I would say, like, it is very difficult. There's stuff we can do, but it is very difficult. It is a very long process that probably will go on for a generation at least, and it should really need, like, some government policy to drive it. So, yeah, those are the key challenges. A lot of stuff.
I want to talk about education. I can imagine HSBC, there's a lot of internal sort of stakeholders, politics, and non-marketing stakeholders who have to try and understand all these three-letter acronyms that you just reeled off. How do you do that? How do you manage those stakeholders and bring them on this journey around, you know, this transition to a future of measurement?
I'm going to introduce a very new concept here that no one heard about before, which is breaking the silos. Like, I'm sure, like, everyone is talking about breaking the silos, and that's what you think, like, you need to do in order to bring together all the stakeholders. I think, like, I've been around long enough to face the truth with breaking the silos is almost an impossible challenge. So what you can do is trying to bridge, like, the gaps between different areas and different departments, trying to navigate and understand, like, where other people are coming from. I think measurement, it is a very good example, and measurement linked to privacy and compliance, it is a very good example of how we worked in the last 3-4 years to overcome, or at least I wouldn't say overcome, I would say try to get better, let's say, at what we do in this space, and making sure that people within the company understand what we're trying to do. And this is down really and getting together with like, first of all, understanding who are your stakeholders internally. And there are very, I mean, HSBC is a very complex organization. We have multiple, like we have business stakeholders, as you can imagine, we have to report to and making sure that they understand that we are doing our job correctly and we're spending the money the most wisely way possible. But we have like internal stakeholders we need to work with, like DP legal, DPO, compliance risk, and everything around digital media really has like a big impact on what they do or what they want to do or they need to do, as much as marketing, I would say. So this is kind of like a shift in paradigm, if you want. Like before, marketing was for marketers. Now marketing is for legal as well and for risk as well. So you really need to spend your time trying to understand, like, first of all, what those people know about what you want to do and how you want to do it. Because I can tell you, like, when I started 4 years ago in HSBC, and I come from a very different background. I worked in tech before on like a consumer technology business. And I stepped in, and I felt like after a few months, like strangled from by legal, because it was like the feeling was like there's nothing I can do. Like you don't want me to do X, Y, Z because there is some kind of risk attached. And I think like we started from there like a very, very good relationship actually. When we started to talk to each other and really try to get under the skin, understand. I tried to understand. What they need to do or what they need to know and try to explain. It is a very, again, it's super complex. Yeah, I don't pretend to be like 100% an expert across the board, but I have a good understanding of what we need to do and how we need to do it. On the other side, like my understanding of the regulation was, I would say, medium, like not the best. Like I had like strong feelings more than like strong knowledge. So we bridged this gap, actually. So they now, those stakeholders, understand much more about marketing and digital marketing than they knew before, which is like great, because if you spend your life doing like legal stuff, like understanding how a DSP works together with an exchange, an SSP, and how a CDP comes in, so many three letters again, it's not easy. At the same time, for me, it wasn't easy to get like under the skin of the policies that we really need to try to interpret. And again, like interpretation is the key word here, because it's not, again, black or white. It is like a big blob of gray in a way. So that makes it even more complicated. But bridging that gap and going through like this process, it was really a process. Has been like very successful, and now we have a very strong relationship, a very strong framework that we use to operate, and we are much quicker in delivering, say, new things and really build on top of what we built before.
Good answer. In terms of those new things, what are you trying to push through now in measurements? What are the things that you're trying to work with your internal stakeholders to test new methodologies, new pieces of tech? Let's get some examples of stuff that you're doing at HSBC.
Yeah, so I mean, from a measurement perspective, I would just echo what actually was said before. So the three key ingredients are MMM attribution, digital attribution, and testing. Specifically, I think geotesting like has a great potential, but any kind of incrementality test that you can prove properly, like it's relevant. So I do think like everyone has the ingredients right. Yeah. So and I'm happy that we are aligned with the people that were here before. I don't think necessarily everyone has a recipe to combine those ingredients. Certainly we don't. We are trying, so we're getting there. And I think like the key point here is like. Again, making sure that like we as a marketers and the business overall understand clearly that deterministic is not a thing anymore. It was maybe a thing before, although questionable. I think it was working a bit better, and people probably wanted to believe that actually it was there. But now it's not anymore, and for sure it won't be in the future. The direction is completely the other one. Yeah. So probabilistic and statistical methodologies are there to stay. They are, say, they are not perfect. MMM model and econometrics like, can tell you a lot, but that won't necessarily be like 100% the truth. So, but that's the best version of the truth you can get, yeah, at least in my opinion. And it is important to try to align everything else, so the rest of the ingredients, around this centerpiece, which is like the statistical method that you use to understand or to gauge how different elements are playing a part in delivering what you need to deliver, which in our case is like sales of specific products or propositions. So what we do is like, in simple terms, like using the MMM as a source of truth and then calibrate the data we see coming from digital platforms and bake experiments on top of that and trying to, again, refine this mix of ingredients to try to get as close as possible to reality, which is, again, it's a journey. We will never get there, but we can get better every now and then. But I think I get a very important thing to keep in mind, again, in this journey, is that done is better than perfect. So there's no point in trying to chase perfection and just, you know, getting stuck in your questioning and continuous like reiteration of something that you never deliver. Try to agree and to make your stakeholders agreeing on a source of truth and stick to it. Is it right? Probably not. It probably is not the right one 100%, but again, like you can test it and retest it and reiterate, but start from something and believe in that that's the truth, because otherwise you will end up doing like scattered exercises here and there, trying to prove different things at different times, because you're not sure, like, or you don't think like that's actually what you're aiming for. And that's, I think, a key component, also thinking about how you combine those data with the AI or like the tools that actually digital platforms give you to optimize your campaigns.
And how much of this statistical modeling and sort of future-looking measurement work are you doing in-house versus how much are you kind of putting out to specialist agencies, and how does that dynamic work in terms of your sort of operating model and all the different stakeholders?
We have a hybrid model at HSBC. I'm a big believer that it is important to have internal capabilities. Actually, one of the key things I've done since I joined the company is to really make an effort to build internal capabilities and internal knowledge. So just to give you like a little bit of context, with those search in-house at HSBC, we have a hybrid model for affiliates and aggregators. So we do partly in-house and partly through an agency. We use agencies actually to deliver our media on programmatic and social, and of course for offline media. But we do have in-house specialists for each one of those verticals. So we are able to really understand what goes on in those specific channels, and making sure that actually we can drive the agency to deliver the best for us, where we don't operate in-house end-to-end. On measurement, we have a similar approach. So we have a marketing effectiveness team internally that manages an external solution. And we work with this external solution, which is Neustar, and in order to deliver, say, the best possible outcome. I do believe like the hybrid model is the best model, because it is very difficult to go all in with in-house. Although like again, like that gives you a lot of control and potentially a lot of pace. But you know, maybe at day one, day two, you really risk to fall behind, because it is very difficult if you're a bank or like I don't know, a retailer, to keep up with the changes that are happening in the media landscape.
And for people in this room who are trying to learn more about measurement and potentially, I guess, sort of accelerate their skills in this area, what type of sort of knowledge and subjects do you think they should be upskilling on to help them get jobs in brands like HSBC?
It really depends. Again, like there are like so many different avenues or opportunities. Yeah, I think like strong analytics and data foundations are super important. Even more now, again, like it can sound like counterintuitive, because I'm saying like we are moving away from deterministic, but it is even more important to have a solid, like a very robust foundation and be, let's say, literate in numeric things, because you need to go like beyond like the scratching the surface, I would say. Yeah? It is very easy, and that's actually like a pitfall that we fall a lot. to look at numbers and trying to make an instant correlation, say like, okay, and that's why it's easy to look at like a data coming from digital platforms and why deterministic is so popular, because you look at click A delivered sales B. That's easy, you know, everyone can see it, and it's reassuring in a way. You open your dashboard, or you show the dashboard to like your CFO, and say, okay, I put like £1 here, I got like a sale worth £3 there. Unfortunately, that's not the reality, and that's why you really need to know your analytics part, and you know, to know numbers. There are numbers and probability wars in order to go the next level, or like down, scratching the surface, and understanding that actually there is so much more. And again, really make peace with the fact that complexity is difficult to disentangle. Yeah. So that would, what is complex will stay complex. So you can try to use like a heuristic to simplify what you see, and that's probably the best way to do it, to tackle this. But complexity is there to stay, and that's because it's really like linked to the human behaviors at the end of the day. I think that was mentioned before at some point, that human behavior, it is a key point to keep in mind. Humans are complex creatures, so if we want to measure their behaviors, we need to face complexity.
Okay, well, on that note, we are out of time. Sam, I don't know if we've got any time for questions or if maybe one. Okay, give me one. Does anyone have a question for Alessandro? No? Maybe none then. That's all good. Thanks so much for joining our session. Thank you to Alessandro.
Thank you.
For joining us today. And enjoy the rest of your day, guys.